You're broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find a fighter, but I see it in you, so we can walk it out. Move mountains, we can walk it out and move mountains.
What we're going to do the next couple days is provide an opportunity to continue our support for Nico and the family. Believe it or not, it's 1 year, about a week away from the 1 year anniversary of the incident. And from the first weekend until the first year anniversary, it's been a mission of mine to make sure that people don't forget that he struggles every day to get a little bit better, to put himself in a position where he can reintegrate himself into the lives of his friends who miss him so much here at Colony High School. So today, tomorrow, we're about spreading positive thoughts and support for Nico. Sometimes we do it in our minds, and sometimes it's late at night, and now we have an opportunity to get it right to Nico. So this is an amazing opportunity to share our thoughts and put them out there for the de novos and our buddy Nico, who keeps fighting.
Nico strong!
Just fight a little longer, my friend. It's all worth it in the end.
Nico is still in the burn unit at the hospital, healing from his latest of 25 surgeries. He has made tremendous progress over the last year. The first day at Westchester Medical Center, doctors told his family he had a 1% chance to survive. He's been
The first time I heard it was crazy. I was shocked. Like,
it hit me with surprise. I heard it and I didn't believe it.
I was shocked. I couldn't believe that it happened.
When I heard about it, I was just devastated. It was sad. The whole community felt it. Everyone was hurt.
It opened my eyes to how quickly your life can change and how much you really got to appreciate just every little thing, because it can be taken away just like that.
It was kind of upsetting because it's like one of our own, and that could happen to any of us any day.
And, it was awful. It's heartbreaking.
As a mom, this was the worst thing that I could have ever imagined. Those days, I mean, I don't even know how I get up and sometimes in the morning, but I think of him, you know what I mean? And if he can fight through all this pain and his life has completely changed, then I can do it. I have to do it.
It was like my world just got turned upside down. Just like your best friend was just got in an accident. Like, you don't know what's going on. I didn't really know much about it.
There's no way to explain. Like, I was in shock, pretty much, like disbelief. Until the next day, me and my friends went down to Westchester, and then it really got real, like, what had happened.
I couldn't believe it at first, and then we had to take time to process it, and, you know, send prayers his way.
Actually, I was there at their house the night that it happened, and me and Bella woke up and were really scared and didn't really know how bad it was at first.
Definitely the worst thing that's ever happened to us. I was sick to my stomach. I didn't know what was happening.
I really didn't know what to think when it happened. I thought it was like a dream, to be honest.
When I heard about it, I was like, what? The tavern bar, that's pretty close.
Mm-hmm.
And at first I didn't know who it was and who was in the accident, but when I learned, I was shocked like everyone else was, and just the fact of learning that it was Nico was that much more heartbreaking.
They finally got me in the car after like 10 minutes, and then we go down there and then we see that he's alive. And as soon as I knew that he was alive, I knew he was gonna make it, just because he's crazy and tough and all mm-hmm. that. So all I did the whole car ride down for 2 hours. It felt like the longest car ride ever, but all I did was have my hands, or my head in my lap, and I was just praying, just please let him be alive.
Right.
Because the way the county police were acting was like he didn't have a shot.
For me, James, I went to bed Blessing. I do like a lot of people is look at Facebook, and I seen that there was a bad accident at Blessings.
Mm-hmm.
And I just remember reading it and thinking to myself, oh God, this is terrible. But I went to bed never thinking that 2 hours later, my phone would ring and my sister's boyfriend would say to me, Davina, you have to get over here. Nico was in a really bad accident. I honestly cannot remember how I got from my bed to my sister's, but I remember everything so vividly from arriving to Alicia's until this day. I walked in and the Connolly police was there, and she was actually on the phone with Dr. Winsky from the Westchester Burn Center, and he said, we have your son here. I am going to be honest with you. It does not look good. I do not know if your son will survive. You need to get here as safely and quickly as you possibly can.
Right.
And with that, the phone dropped out of Alicia's hand and she fell, and I grabbed her and I held her and I picked her back up and I looked her in her face and I said, look at me, let's go. Let's get there. He's going to be okay. And when I got in the car, I remember just like Michael, that whole ride, all we could do was pray. That's all you can do at a time like this is pray. And I remember, and I said to my husband, and he can validate it, this is not it for Nico. We're not gonna lose him. There's a reason for this. There's a purpose. God has a purpose for him. And now here we are almost 365 days later, and we know Nico's purpose.
Before October 28th, I would have given you a short list of people who I thought were the strongest people that I know. And after that date, and to this day, you're at the top of my list, brother. You are the strongest person that I know. Keep up the fight, man.
What's up, Nico? It's McGee. Hope everything's good, bro. Always think about you back home. Everybody's fighting for you. You got it, champ. Nico strong.
I mean, I miss you talking about the Dallas games. There's not many fans around here, so we're 3-3 right now. Tough season so far. Hopefully we can keep fighting. But Nico strong. Got to hope the X for you, bud.
Oh, I want to tell him that I love him. I miss him. When he comes back, we're just gonna it's going to be like a celebration because we haven't seen him so much. Do what we always do, hang out, play Madden, play at 2K, whatever. Whatever game he want to play is up to him.
All right. Miss you so much, brother. Praying for you every day.
And I just hope all the best for Nico. Recover soon. Come back soon. Take care, Nico.
Just keep fighting, man. We know you're going to beat it. We know you're going to do well. You're going to get through it. Just keep fighting. We're all praying for you.
Continue to fight that battle that you're fighting, bud, and know that you're going to stay strong and know that you're going to win in the long run. And you know that I'm here for you if you need anything. And look forward to seeing you soon.
Nico, I'm so glad you're getting better, and I hope to see you soon. Nico strong.
Nico, keep fighting. Very strong. We miss you. Nico strong.
We miss you and we all love you. We're happy you're getting better. Nico strong.
Again, bro, I miss you. I love you. All positivity. Keep fighting. Nico strong.
I miss and love you, Nico. I'll see you soon. Nico strong.
We're all so proud of you, Nico. Can't wait to see you. Nico strong.
Awesome.
We love you, Nick. We're very proud of you and we all miss you so much. Nico strong.
If he hears my voice, you know how much I love you. You know how much we love you all together as a unit. This experience, it brought us together, not only because of everything that happened, but because we know that it didn't just happen to him, it can happen to anyone in a split second. Like, I feel like it changed everyone's actions. Like, be more aware, you should know, like, keep your eyes open, and just treat people the same with love.
I want him to be the same exact person that he was, including like all the jokes and like the comments that he would make, just being sarcastic, and like, because that's what I miss the most about him.
Nico, I miss you down deep, brother. I miss you very much. Hope to see you soon and get better.
Nico, you literally inspired everything about me. Everything I do is for you. When I think about softball and that I don't want to give up, I think about you, because you have come so far and you still have a ways to go, but you are literally a champ, Neek. I love you.
Bella really misses you all the time, and I do too, and
I just really hope you get better.
Nico, I miss you and I love you, and keep fighting because you're doing so amazing. Like, a lot of people were expecting you not to fight as hard as you're doing right now, but just keep fighting.
Keep fighting, you're doing a really good job, and I love you, and I hope I get to see you soon.
On behalf of all the Gilroys, we all miss you, and we hope that someday we can all go to camp again or play golf and have good times.
I want to tell him that he inspires me every day and that I cannot wait until he comes home and we can get back to the way things were, and nothing will ever change between me and him or anybody here in Colony, and that Colony misses him every day.
Man, I miss you so much, Nico. Like, you don't understand. I think about you all the time. Now, everything I do, you know, whether it be in the gym, football, you're always in the back of my mind, whether it be son little, like me playing my video games, or son, not a day goes by, but I miss you.
Yeah, I miss you too, kid. And we just want you back here, and, you know, we all love you.
You have an edge about you, Nico, and I know that edge is probably what's going to wind up getting you through your life and ultimately your success in it. So, I really look forward to seeing you, to be perfectly honest with you. So, I'll look forward to that day.
Get better really quick so he could help me with my homework and just aggravate me.
Here he is, 365 days almost, laying in a bed. Hasn't really been up yet, hasn't really talked yet, but he has done so much for people, so much. And we are never gonna be able to repay him. He has restored people's faith. He has united people that didn't even know each other. He has taken separate groups at the high school. You know, growing up, you have different cliques. Mm-hmm. He's united them as one. He has formed this amazing sense of camaraderie, love. I personally will never be able to repay him. He has honestly brought out the best in me. Everything I do, morning, noon, and night, is for Nico. I love you, buddy. You know Aunt Davina loves you.
I definitely can never repay him. He's taught me how to never give up and always try to do what you need to do. You know, anything within your power. And he's taught me how to be a man, actually, because I had to step up for my family in a tough time. So a 17-year-old kid taught me how to be a man.
See what I'm saying?
So I can't repay him for that. But all I just want to say is that I love you a lot, Neek, and that you're going to do good things. We're going to make a negative to a positive. And mm-hmm. Let's go, champ. And thank you.
Thank you to everybody, Nico's tribe.